அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். திஸ் இஸ் நற்பவி, நற்பவி டைம்ஸ், இனிய தமிழ் கிளாஸஸ். நற்பவி நேரம் இனிய தமிழ் வகுப்புக்கு உங்கள் அனைவரையும் அன்புடன் வரவேற்கின்றேன். ஐ எம் ஹாப்பி டு ஷேர் அ ஃபியூ திங்ஸ் அபவுட் மை லாங்குவேஜ், மை கல்ச்சர், தி சோஷியல் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் அண்ட் தி சீக்ரெட் சயின்சஸ் பிஹைண்ட் ஆல் திஸ் ப்ராக்டிஸ். அண்ட் ஐ எம் கிளாட் தட் யூ ஆர் ஹியர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் இன் லேர்னிங் தமிழ். ஸோ வித் திஸ் சீரீஸ் இனிய தமிழ் வகுப்புகள், யூ வில் பி ஏபிள் டு ரீட் அண்ட் ரைட் இன் தமிழ் ஸோ ஃபாஸ்ட், ஸோ அப்ரோப்ரியேட் அண்ட் இன் அ ஃபனியர் வே. For your reference, I have given below the links for the books which I will be following. Have you ever wondered that coming to Tamil Nadu, or you just want to surprise or impress any Tamil friends, or you just want to sing along with the Tamil songs with proper pronunciation, knowing the meaning, you are exactly where you have to be. So let's begin. What I show here is the basic structure of Tamil language. So as in any language, we have vowels, consonants and combined letters in Tamil. So speaking of vowels, I would like to show you one thing. Vowels in Tamil are called uyir eluthukal and consonants in Tamil are called mey eluthukal. Let me tell you the meaning of uyir eluthukal and mey eluthukal. Uyir literally means soul and mey denotes body. So uyir eluthukal means letters of soul and mey eluthukal means bodily letters. So next comes the combined letters, which is denoted by uyir mey eluthukal. So when the soul combines with body, we get life. So these uyir mey eluthukal can also be known as lively letters. And about this, eluthukal means letters, and for a single letter we have eluthu. As you can see, the suffix kal in eluthu, eluthukal denotes plurality, and the absence of kal means singularity. Coming back to the structure, so we have 12 vowels, 18 consonants and 216 combined letters. Also we have a single special character. So in total we have 247 letters in Tamil language. So 247 is a huge number, isn't it? But don't panic. Once you get to know the tricks, numbers doesn't matter. Let us begin with the real reading and writing concept. Today we will be seeing two consonants, two vowels and four combined letters. The first sound what we will be seeing now is A sound. So in Tamil we have two notes for each sounds. So for A sound we have a short note and a long note. Let me tell you how it sounds. A sound in Tamil is A. Is short note and A is a long note. This is how first sound is A sound, and this is how we write A. And this is a short noted A, and this is a long noted A. A, A, as in cat and cot. Cat. And you can also say car. The sound is a and a. So for writing the script, once I was teaching my non-Tamil friends how to write Tamil, and they were looking at the script and they just asked me, how should I draw this? They not even thought it as a script or a language. They thought our Tamil language as some drawing. They asked me, how do I draw this? So let me tell you how to draw these letters. The sound A, you have to start with a spiral and you bring it down. You draw a straight line, stop it here, cut with a straight line. This is A. And for A, long noted A sound, you have to add one more spiral. That's it. So this is A, A. We have two levels for each sound. This is a short noted A sound and this is a long winged A sound. A, A. And coming to the next. We'll see consonants. We have two consonants here. The first consonant is K sounded, and the second one is S sound or CH sound. CH sound. You can call it as S sounded. So, wait. Right here. First one is K sound and second one is CH, pitch sound, CH sound. So for K sounded consonant, this is how you write. Start from here. This is called ik. So one more thing, consonants always comes with a dot over the letter. And so whenever you see a dot, that letter is a consonant, and you call this letter as ik, as you will say is or its. You will be calling this as ik, and this e sound is for the dot above the letter. And next comes the second consonant. This is similar to the first consonant, but you'll be stopping the line right here. Stop it, that's all. And consonant comes with a dot over the letter. This is known as itch. Itch, as in itch. But the T sound is silent, so you'll be calling itch. So now we have the two consonants, ik and itch. So let me write those vowels and consonants one more time in here, so it will be easy for us. Okay. Ik. H. Ik. Itch. Itch as in itch. H, isn't it? T is silent. Okay. H, and here is a. Ah. So, ik plus a is ka. We don't want this I sound in the combined letters. We leave off the I sound and the sound becomes ka. And for the long notes, ik plus a is ka. Similarly, each plus a is cha, each plus a cha, and each plus a cha. So this is how we write ka and ka. You write the same consonants for ka, but without a dot. That's it. You don't want to keep a dot for ka. If you keep a dot over ka, it becomes ik. Similarly, for cha, you write the consonant without a dot. And for ka, we write the consonant again, but we need to denote the sound, elongated sound, with the supporting letter ka. So this supporting letter makes this letter sound ka. So for cha, you write the consonant cha and add the supporting letter cha. So whenever you see a letter with the supporting followed by the supporting letter, that letter is ends with a sound, elongated a sound. So now we know 8 letters: a, ka, ka, cha, cha, and this including these two consonants ik and ich. Isn't it quite easy? You learned 8 letters in a single shot. Okay people, that's all for today's session. See you next time with some more words. Until then, bye bye. Thank you, Nandri.